Welcome to this brief guide on how to perform date calculations in Excel. Previously, when I wanted to calculate how many days there were between two particular dates, I used to do what everyone does, and that was head to the web and find a website to calculate it for me. That was until I realized I could do this natively in Excel. So today I'm going to show you how to do it yourself. Here you can see I have a couple of tables, the first of which has today's date and then my next birthday, and I want to calculate how many days there are until my next birthday. So the first thing I'll need to do is to enter in today's date into that today's date field, which in this case it's the 31st of August 2023. Now if I didn't want to type this in manually, there are actually a couple of other ways that I can do to enter in today's date. The first of which is a keyboard shortcut, which is Control plus semicolon. This works on both Mac and Windows and will enter in today's date automatically for me. However, this date is just purely today's date. It's not a formula, so it's not going to update automatically if I come back to this spreadsheet later on. So instead, I'm actually going to use a formula, which is equals today and then an open and closed parentheses. This is the formula that will keep this Excel sheet updated automatically with today's date every time I come back to it. And I can see that formula right there in the formula bar. Now that I've got today's date set up, I need to enter in the next cell, which is my next birthday. So in this case, I'm going to enter in the 17th of June, 2024, because that'll be the date for my next birthday. And now how do I find out the difference between these two dates? Well, it's going to be quite a simple formula. We're going to treat them just like we would any two numbers in an Excel spreadsheet. So I'm going to put in equals, and then I'm going to select my first date, and then I'm going to subtract the second date from the first date. Super simple formula. When I hit enter, what you'll see is that I have minus 291 days. Now the reason why we're getting a negative integer will become apparent very soon, but what we can simply do here to get a positive integer is by simply selecting the cell with our answer and modifying our formula slightly. So we're going to have equals ABS, which will give us an absolute function, and then we're going to put our D5 minus D6 into parentheses, and then when I hit enter, what's going to happen instead is I get a positive 291. So Excel will just simply give me the absolute value as opposed to the minus or positive. Now the question is how does it work? How does Excel figure this out? Well, this is easy to explain by simply changing the cell format, which we can do in our ribbon, or if you want, you can use the keyboard shortcut Control 1 on Windows or Command 1 on Mac OS, and that will bring up your format cell option. And if we change the format of these cells into a number, what you'll see is that these dates are actually going to be converted into numbers. And that is how Excel is finding out the difference between these two particular dates. We can show this off as an example here though, by simply typing in, for instance, the 1st of January 1900. Now there's a reason that I chose this particular date. And the reason is because when I head over and change the cell format into a number, what you'll see is that this particular date is date number one. So Excel starts all of its date formulas from the 1st of January 1900. Now the reason that this is important is because if you have any dates that you're trying to calculate that just happen to predate 1900, such as for instance the 31st of December 1899, if I was to try and convert this over to a number, nothing's going to happen. It just stays exactly the same. So just keep in mind that this won't work for dates that are earlier than 1900. And so now I know exactly how this is all working. What if I wanted to tailor this formula a little bit? I know that there's 291 days until my birthday, but what if I only wanted to count the number of days that are work days between those particular dates? Is there a way for me to do that? Well, surprise, surprise, there is. There's a dedicated formula, which is equals net work days, and then in parentheses, I will include those two dates separated by a comma. So I have my start date, comma, and then I enter in my second date, which will be my birthday, close the parentheses, and then I can hit enter. And what you'll see is that there are exactly 208 work days between now and my birthday. Not too bad at all. And now that we know how Excel treats these dates like numbers, let's use it in another example. My lovely cat Dusty, her last vaccination was on the 16th of August, 2023. And the vet has told me that she's going to need a booster shot in around about 6 months. So I can use a formula and treat that date just like a regular number. So I'm going to select that date and I'm going to add 180 days to it because it's roughly 6 months. And then by hitting enter, I'm going to get an output in a date format because Excel understands that I'm working with dates. and I can see that her next booster shot is due on the 12th of February, 2024. And that is how you perform date calculations in Excel. I hope you found this tip extremely useful and it saves you plenty of time in the future, and I'll catch you in my next video. Thanks for watching. If you'd like to see more content like this, be sure to check out the channel, and if you like what you see, don't forget to hit that subscribe button.